Hi, this time a little bit of a different video for me because a few devices are being picked up today. My R24 Zoom recorder is already picked up and my Behringer mixer is going to be picked up later today. And probably my MPC Live is going to be picked up very soon as well because I'm selling it or in the process of selling it. Before it's going to be picked up, I want to tell you the reasons why I am selling it. I used the MPC Live for about 6 months, and in this time I mainly tried to figure out a way to incorporate it in my workflow, in my Ableton workflow, and use it with other synthesizers and control it from within the DAW. Although I managed to come up with a few ways to incorporate it, it's not really intuitive and helping my workflow. In fact, it's slowing me down considerably. So yeah, and then I thought to myself, why am I making it so hard for myself? Why don't just sell it and see if there's something else out there that fits my workflow and what enables me to work faster or at least in a more pleasant way. It's not because I don't like the MPC Live, it's just not for me. So there are a lot of good things I can tell about the MPC Live, and I will name a few, and also things I don't like, and perhaps the things I expected. So yeah, okay, what do I like? Well, the screen, of course. The screen is very nice to be able to sit on the couch and work out ideas, and instead of working like an Electribe 2 sampler, for instance, you can see everything you're doing on the screen, and that's really nice. What I also like is the possibility to add effects on virtually anything and everything, and that you have separate a channel and pad mixer. In the way I am trying to use it, I have to use the audio outputs because I only want to use it in a standalone mode. So that's very nice. You can, but it's also nice, you can layer the samples. It's not something I didn't expect, but it's nice that you can. And without sacrificing other stuff, you can sample, layer samples, for instance, on one pad, and that's nice. What I also like is that you can use LFO modulation and filters and effects and all the other stuff that you can do. And in general, I like the standalone mode because you can pick it up and sit on the couch or anywhere else. You can take it with you in the car and sit in on a bench in a park, and you have really a good battery life. So it's not it's going to die on you when you're 30 minutes into your session. No, it's all great. What I also like is the XY pad and the VST plugins. The VST plugins that came with firmware update 2.3, 2.4, I don't know. Because then you're not so limited to just using samples. You can create your own sounds, and that's really nice too. And what I also like is the fact that you can really create a not so complicated song in a short amount of time. And you're being pushed forward continuously to complete that song. You can create a sequence and copy it and leave stuff out or add stuff, and it's really great. But that's when you're just editing in the MPC Live. If you want to use it standalone as a sampler, then things change rather quick. And that was what I was trying to do in the last 6 months. I was trying to find a way to use it as a sampler and control it from within Ableton. So what I don't like is when I use the MPC Live without the MPC software in a DAW situation. And then you can see that you're quite limited to what you can do and control in the MPC Live. And therefore, for me, the standalone mode is limiting. Very limiting, in fact. The fact that you don't have multi-timbral support and a load of other features that are most requested, that's holding this device back really, especially for me, the things I can't do are exactly the things I expected it could do. So, yeah. What I also don't like is the fact that normally you can sample something with a sampler and save that piece of a sample, or you can tweak it and then save the sample, but you can't do it here. You have to put it in a project, and it's very cumbersome. And also the editing, and it's not really intuitive. I don't know what it is. Perhaps it's just me, because I'm using it in another way than other people that do like the MPC and the MPC style of working. So what did I expect? When I bought it, I really did expect a fully fledged multi-timbral sampler and with full MIDI implementation, and also the possibility to really control the unit from within a DAW instead of the unit controlling software as a controller. And the moment I found that out, it all fell into place why certain stuff is missing. Because in my view, it's my opinion, in my view, Akai made software, MPC software, and made controllers for it. And afterwards, they made an MPC, a standalone MPC. And then you can do all these things in a standalone box wherever you are. Yeah, but what they kind of didn't mention, in my opinion, is that you still am working with the software. That if you want to continue your song, that you have to export it one way or the other to the software, and then you can further arrange it and whatnot, use extra tracks and plugins and what have you. So now I know why Akai makes some decisions and why they leave some stuff out. For instance, multi-timbrality. What you want is that you can play a track with the pads and play another track via MIDI on the USB at the same time. But you can't do that. But that's one thing that's been under consideration to develop. Because it fits their, how do you call it? It fits their goal. And their goal is definitely not my goal. And what I also expect was MIDI over USB in standalone mode. I don't mind plugging these MIDI DIN cables, but I expected it to do. What I also expect was audio over MIDI. What I got was no USB functionality at all if I don't use it in controller mode. Why did I expect MIDI and audio over USB, or at least MIDI over USB? It's because MIDI over USB, my base station 2 has MIDI over USB, and my 12-year-old Fire STI has MIDI and audio over USB, and the new, or relatively new Digitech has MIDI and audio over USB. So yeah, I don't want to sound harsh. I'm just a bit disappointed, and it's all because I had a certain view and a certain expectation, and it's not met. But nonetheless, do I regret buying the MPC Live? No, I really don't. It's really a nice piece of equipment. It's just not for me. Am I sad to seeing it go? Yeah, really. I thought a lot about it. Just to keep it and see if version 2.6 or 3.0 is gonna give the features what I want. But now I think I understand what Akai is planning with this device. I really, really don't expect anything, perhaps some features, but I really don't expect all of what I want. I don't even expect 5%. So then if you know that and you know it's just holding you back, get rid of it. And it's not with the MPC. I got rid of lots of stuff. I got rid of the Electribe 2 sampler for the same reason. It just didn't live up to my expectations. But that device was a few hundred euros. But I did expect it from a 1,000 euro device. So don't expect too much. Really do your research. I didn't. I really didn't think about things like MIDI implementation and such. That's so normal to have on a device these days. So yeah, I really didn't expect that certain things were left out in the way it did or it does in this device. So yeah, what am I going to do now? Well, I'm going the other route. If I want to buy a controller to control software, I'm going to buy a Push 2 because my workflow is an Ableton workflow. And that way I don't have to adapt to a completely new way of working. Really, that sums it up. But it's not really a happy end. and I don't like not having a happy end. So what am I going to do? I'm probably going to buy a Push or a Launchpad Pro. I really don't know yet. I want to buy some Electron gear if I can. Or just replace my mixer and my recorder with a Zoom LiveTrack L12. And perhaps, yeah, buy something else for the MPC. I don't know yet, but you will see in one of my next videos. So stay tuned. And see you then. Bye.